Joining us now to further discuss their support for this latest push to amend the charter are attorneys Evaristo Gana and Dante Atienza of the Gana Atienza Avisado Law Offices. Gentlemen, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having us.
All right. So we're going to talk about the ad now, and everybody's talking about it, gentlemen. When was the ad first conceptualized?
This was conceptualized by the ad agency, probably to spur public discussion and raise public awareness. And the creative concept is left to them. But it's between the proponents, that is, in our case, we're representing their firma, who's handling that.
All right. So you're entirely left the conceptualization to the ad agency. And during this time, though, what kind of impact, as you were conceptualizing it together with the ad agency, what kind of impact did you want this ad to have?
Well, actually, the ad was conceptualized, I believe, because we were not part of the conceptualization of this ad. I believe to spur public discussion about a public initiative.
Okay, attorney.
Initiative.
Yeah, Attorney Gana, your audio and your signal is coming in choppy. Can you say that again, please?
This is just to spur public discussion for the people's initiative, just in case there are certain provisions in the charter that that has to be changed so that we can be, well, we can focus on the changing economic conditions and geopolitical conditions that we are right now. Mm-hmm. Because remember, the 1987 Constitution is about 37 years old already. So probably there are things that should be changed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there's no question about that. I think your motive and your advocacy, that's very clear. But with the way this was presented, let me go to Attorney Atienza now. At which point did the law firm say this is a good attack on the issue here? This is going to be a good message to the audience about what we want to achieve. Attorney Atienza.
Well, in the first place, I think kung ang aim is to gain attention from the public, that ad achieved that already. Napapag-usapan. At yun ang talagang aim namin. Dalhin sa level ng charter change.
Mm-mm.
At sa parte ng pirma, nandito kami sa punto na we are conducting consultations on the ground para malaman ano talaga yung gustong palitan. Napapanahon ba ang pagpapalit ng charter change? Mm-mm. At ano yung mga kailangan palitan?
Mm-mm. Where in the ad did it say this? Is it time to tinker with the Constitution? Ano ba yung kailangan palitan? Which point in the ad, because I've seen it, which point in the ad did this, was this message conveyed? Attorney Atienza.
Yeah. I think malinaw naman yung substance ng ad. On education, unemployment, economy. Yun ang main message ng ad. Baguhin at maaaring hindi na napapanahon, maaaring hindi na akma sa mga pangangailangan ng bansa. I think the people should be more circumspect into looking at the message of the ad.
Uh-huh. I think people are now saying exactly the same thing to the people behind the ad, that maybe you guys should have been more circumspect when you used the term Ed Sapuera, that it was divisive. People are now saying it's divisive. even some proponents, even those who share the same advocacy, were turned off by it. So what do you say to that? How important was it that Ed Sapuera, that theme throughout the ad, was used to drive that message? Let me go to Attorney Gana.
Well, actually, the creative content of that ad was actually made by the ad agency, and the proponent Pirma, well, agreed to that because it would spur public discussion, and I think it has achieved that. And now, when you talk about the message of the ad itself, you would see that it is advocating the discussion on how to best resolve poverty aggregation, unemployment, labor, and all the economic factors that could help the Philippines become resilient and more sustainable economy.
No, but several times already, I'm sorry to cut you there, Attorney Ganda, but several times already in this interview, you always point to the ad agency. You're the client. You had the final say. You signed off on this. So you believe and you stand by the use of Ed Sapuera there. And you don't believe, or do you believe, that it's divisive, that it's turning off even proponents of charter change? Any one of you could answer.
Yeah, I don't think that is to some extent divisive. I think there's no monopoly of what a person perceives. Walang mga kapagsabi na yung isa ang tingin niya tama yung kulang, tama yung 1987 Constitution, o kulang yung 1987 Constitution, o enough na ba yung 1987 Constitution. It's a matter of perspective. Maaring sa tingin nung gumawa at yung nung nag-initiate, eh, posibleng yun ang kanyang itingin. Kami, either way, ang punto namin dito is maipalahad namin sa tao kung ano yung magandang pamamaraan para mapag-usapan ang charter change.
Gaano ka-importante?
Wala naman sanang pumigil dun sa pag-aakyat namin dito sa level ng public discussion. Kasi in a democracy, yung exchange of ideas is very, very essential and very important.
No, it's I get you. I get your point. But I'm also bringing into the discussion the attention that the ad had gotten since it aired, and the use of Ed Sapuera. It's not enjoining. I've talked to one political analyst. We're going to talk to him again later. I talked to Professor Edmund Tayo yesterday. I'm going to talk to him again after I talk to you gentlemen. And this is what he said yesterday. He said the ad did not enjoin the public to participate in the discussion. In fact, it didn't speak that the constitution that you were speaking of was a constitution for all. It's supposed to enjoin. It's supposed to elevate the discussion, and that didn't happen with your ad. Your reaction to that?
Probably the ad, as the opinion of the person who criticized the ad, probably the ad did not enjoin. Probably the message was not clear, but that is his opinion. But the way we see it, we have already raised public awareness, people are talking about it, and then probably, we are not competent as lawyers here, we're not competent to discuss, for example, what's best for the economy. We don't have the competence or the expertise for that. So we need experts, we need public discussion, even with the farmers, the fisher folk, and even the businessmen and big business. They might, because they have a stake in this.
Then why couldn't you have said exactly that in the ad?
Well, probably looking back, you're right. But at that point in time, that is what the ad agency recommended. So Pirma had to go with that.
It is reported that your clients pitched in to pay for the ad. Is that true?
Yeah, that's true.
May I know how much you spent for the ad?
I would not know exactly right now. I cannot recall how much it was.
And when the ad was conceptualized, did it emanate from your law firm first, or did your client say, we want an ad out there, help us do it?
Actually, it was the client's choice. So ultimately, the ad was aired based on the agreement of the ad agency and the client.
Why did it have to go through you guys then?
We are the counsels of Firma, and of course, we expect legal challenges that will come out later. Probably it will go all the way up to the Supreme Court. And then we are here to assist our client with the legal aspect of this initiative.
So it's Firma itself. Let's get that straight. It's Firma itself that paid for this ad.
Yes, ma'am.
Or is it Firma and other clients?
Firma and other individuals.
Mm-hmm. And these individuals wouldn't want their names to be shared publicly?
Probably later they would come out. Probably they think that it's not yet the time. That's why they haven't come. Didn't come out yet. Who they were or who the proponents are.
Are these clients in politics? Are they sitting politicians? Attorney Atienza.
We would not know. It is Firma and all their allies that are. I think we're the ones who raised the funds.
But is there anything wrong with that? Do you think? As lawyers of Firma, that they may have sitting politicians who had paid for this ad?
Oh, if it's a personal contribution, we don't think any there would be an implication on that.
And there's nothing wrong. Yeah, go ahead.
There will be a problem if the public funds will be is being used. For so long as it is a private fund, I don't think there's any complication with that.
There's another thing that's being said about the ad, that it reeks of revisionism and that it is misleading, that it points to the 1987 Constitution as the root cause for all the problems that we're encountering right now. But it does not say anything about the people who failed the Filipino people in the implementation of the 1987 Constitution. Your reaction to that, gentlemen? Let's go with Attorney Atienza first and then to Attorney Gana. Go ahead.
Well, everybody is welcome to criticize the ad. As for us, what the ad achieved is it created a stir among the people, and our purpose of elevating the matter for a public discussion is already achieved. Again, for us, the message of the substance of the message of the ad is already there, that we want change because we need an improvement for to address the issues on unemployment, agriculture, business environment, and everything, education.
Attorney Gana?
Well, actually, you said a while ago that there is no substance, they find no substance in the ad. Well, practically, we are just pointing an avenue in which people would discuss how we can alleviate our situation right now with regards to the economy, like what Attorney Atienza said, unemployment, agriculture, and the like. So we can become we can have a better economic environment here in the Philippines, well, up par with world standards.
Now that, as you've said, gentlemen, that the ad achieved your goal, which is to spur discussion, and that's what your claim is this the last of any initiatives coming from your group? Should the public wait for more ads coming from Firma and your law office?
We were just informed that they would improve the ad.
Because, they will improve it? Why? I thought there was nothing wrong with it.
No. Well, of course. Well, the client is also responsive to how the people react to the ad. I remember, this is still in process. it is still a moving process. So, responsive naman yung pirma dun sa mga reaction ng tao.
Mm. So, meron pang kasunod?
Every day, there should be an improvement. Katulad ng ginagawa sa mga public consultation, malalaman. Hindi lang naman, the ad does not address all the issues na gustong palitan. Dahil yung gumawa ng ad at yung mga proponent, hindi naman, we do not have the monopoly of knowing the problem. Kaya nga man nagkakaroon ng public consultation on the grounds para malaman ano ba talaga ang gusto ninyong palitan. Kung gusto nyo man, napapanahon na ba?
Oo. Hindi ba dapat nauna yun?
Well, well actually, talking about whether the new ad or the ad that was already aired should be first,
mm-mm,
we are not competent enough to say that. And probably, you're right. We should have aired that first and should... Well, it's already there. It's already out there. And
yeah.
What's better is at least people are aware whether they're against it, for it, criticize it. At least they're talking about, okay, there is a people's initiative.
Mm. All right.
Should be aware of.
All right.
And we should guard. Let's.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm pretty sure attorneys Agana and Atienza, I'm pretty sure this is not going to be the last time that I'll be talking to you both. Thank you so much for joining us and accepting our Zoom invitation. Yes,
can I just add one? Well, lahat ng ginagawa, ang dulo naman nito ay ilalahad pa rin sa tao. Tao pa rin ang boboto kung ano yung nararapat. Tama ba na magkaroon ng plebisito para sa pagpapalit ng ating saligang batas?
Mm.
'Di ba? Hindi naman ito sa ngayon, nandito tayo sa magulong stage na nagdidiskusyon. Pero ang pagbabago ay mangyayari kung kagustuhan ito ng nakararaming Pilipino pagdating ng plebisito.
Kung dumating tayo doon.
Yes.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. Attorneys Agana and Atienza, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon of the they're the law firm behind Pirma, who was the client for the organization behind the push to amend the charter ad. I hope first of all, let me just go back because it's been nagging me since you brought it out. So you're going to go back to the drawing board. You're going to refine this ad. When is it going to come out?
I'm not saying we're going back to the drawing board. I'm saying we continuously improve what is being, because the client and our group, all the people in the advocacy is responsive to also to the criticisms that we're getting, criticisms or the actions. So nothing is permanent. Everything in here, di ba? So ang aim naman natin lahat is to improve everything, eh. Di ba? Para magkaroon ng mas malinaw na public discussion.
I mean, if there's anything, this is just one ad that we're talking about, and this is not even, I mean, this is just an ad. Is this portentous of what's going to happen once real discussions take place? It's going to be one very challenging route towards that decision, whether the charter needs to be amended or not. How are you gearing up for that? Let me go to Attorney Agana.
Well, actually, we've been preparing for this, and we expect not only legal challenges, because in the public discussion, we don't know what will come out. Actually, we don't know how to address the problems in agriculture, for example. So we leave it to the experts, we leave it to the people to do the consultations. We leave it to the people's initiative. What the results would be. And of course, whatever the results would be, as Attorney Atienza said, it will be the Filipino people who is going to decide whether it's needed or not.
Attorney Evaristo Ogana, Managing Partner, and Attorney Dante Sinonbi Atienta, Senior Partner of the Ghana Atienta Avisado Law Firms. Thank you so much for joining us today, gentlemen. Till the next time. Take care.